Thanks for clicking on News-Sentinel.com. I'm multimedia editor Dan Vance. Justin Kenny out this week. Hall of Famer Reggie Hayes in. I'd say it's an upgrade.
This might be like, you know, Lou Gehrig taking over the basketball video, so I don't know.
I'll take it. Maybe you'll have good luck. He said one team was going to play this week. We have two teams playing, both Blackhawk Christian and Westview advancing to the semi-state round. Reggie, we're going to start with Blackhawk Christian. They play Southwood at Huntington North in the first game on Saturday. Tell me a little bit about this Southwood team. Is this the best matchup for a team against Blackhawk Christian all year?
You know, I think it'll be interesting because while Southwood doesn't have super height, they have a lot of diversity on their offense. They have a lot of quickness. They're obviously well coached. They lost two games early, and then they've only lost to Oak Hill, who's at this level as well, since then. And I think it's going to be a great matchup. I have to believe that they have a plan to deal with Blackhawk's size with their quickness.
Now, a lot of this coming into this game, Blackhawk starts their offense and really starts defensively with Jalen Moll. Peyton Trexler, 19.8 points a game, 5.3 assists per game, 3.8 steals per game. Maybe the most Jalen Moll-like point guard Jalen Moll's had to face this year. Does that start Southwood on the upward trend in this game?
Well, I think if you're able to disrupt Jalen, and you've seen Blackhawk a number of times, if you could, which is very hard to do,
very hard.
If you could disrupt him and make him work a little bit harder, then conversely, on the other end, he has to do that as well.
Sure.
So I think that's a great matchup, and those two players right there, whoever gets the best of that may have the edge. He may give the rest of the team the edge.
What do you think as far as the height comes into this? Obviously, Southwood has a little bit of height at 6'4". Does it hurt some of the guys for Blackhawk Christian that are not as quick? Drake Thompson, Jared Hofer, who have contributed throughout this tournament, they're not as quick. Does it hurt them a little bit that Southwood's true post for Southwood, as they have them, are a little bit quicker?
Well, I think that and the fact that Southwood 575 threes attempted.
True.
Okay, I think they're going to be playing somewhat of a perimeter game,
yeah.
Which I assume, not having seen Southwood, but I assume that means lots of ball movement. Mm-hmm. Okay, so they're using their quickness to move the ball. That's going to play into those bigger guys. Can they get in position quick enough? Southwood's going to fire it up from three. And if they, you know what happens if a team gets hot from three.
You happened to get out to Blackhawks practice earlier this week. What are some things, you know, a little bit of a first experience for you with them this year? What are some things that you noticed with this Blackhawk team as far as their chemistry and just kind of how loose they are going into this week?
Well, I think they're a very confident team, as they would be. Mm-hmm. You know they would. They play that tough schedule. They play kind of an SAC-like schedule for the size of school they have. The fact they have so many seniors, I think, is just a huge key. You know, we look at that in high school basketball. We look at it in college basketball, you know. Rarely in college basketball do you have senior-oriented teams because of those top-tier teams anyway. But when you do, that plays a big factor. And I think Blackhawk's going to really rely on that, okay, that they've been here before. Caleb First is a freshman. But as Mark Davidson told me, he's played in so many big games, I guess, if you want to call them big games in AAU-type mm-hmm. ball. He's played in big situations, okay?
Yeah.
Pressure, elite, good competition. So being a freshman doesn't make that much a difference for him, and he's surrounded by all these seniors. So I think they will try to use that veteran savvy.
Talk about Frankie Davidson real quick. Has had a really diverse year. You told me earlier the kid is shooting the ball ridiculously well, probably even more than most people realize.
50% from three-point range with 156 attempts. Okay, I can shoot 50% if I take two and maybe one of them goes in.
Right.
But, that's incredible because you have to believe that teams know he's such a threat there. Mm-hmm. So they're defending it well, and he's still making those shots.
So it's almost kind of like a mirror image. You talked about Southwood is going to play on the perimeter. They shoot the ball very well.
Right.
If you told me to pick Blackhawks' two best shooters percentage-wise, I'm going Devin Donaldson and Luke Sassmanshausen. So maybe kind of a very similar game that Blackhawks are going to play, and they're going to have to draw Southwood out on the perimeter.
Yeah, and I do think that, you know, to go back to Blackhawks size, that can be a factor because if they're able to disrupt Southwood enough that they're not hitting 50% of threes, then they're in position to be in a better situation by controlling the boards.
Blackhawk Christian and Southwood, they will play the 4 o'clock game in Huntington North Saturday. Reggie Hayes will be there. I'll be there. I'm sure both of the communities will be there, well represented at Huntington North.
Oh, yes.
Trip to the state finals on the line for Blackhawk, possibly a rematch with Bar Reeve in the state finals, a team they beat by 20 earlier this year. Got to get through Southwood first.
Feels like a championship game, doesn't it?
It does feel like a championship game.
Yeah, I mean, it is a semi-state championship, but it feels like the winner of this game has the inside track to win the state title.
Absolutely. Following that game at 6 o'clock at Huntington North, Westview 28-1 from the NECC. They'll battle Oak Hill. And Westview's just kind of rolled through the year. Had a kind of a letdown loss to Fairfield earlier in the season, but have just kind of rolled through everybody else. Oak Hill may be on a different level than what Westview's seen.
You know, I would say that Westview has played. I mean, they play competition. I mean, they play bigger schools during the course of the year. You get to this point, okay, you're playing the best of the best. And Oak Hill has only lost. I mean, they've lost five games, but all of these teams that they've lost to are tremendous teams. I mean, they didn't lose any. They didn't lose any so-so teams along the way. You know, even played Covington Catholic of Kentucky, which is 31-4, one of the top teams in Kentucky. That is a good team. Westview, however, I have been impressed with the fact if you can go through a season with one loss, and the loss was overtime to a conference team that you just played previously, it's kind of like those ACC tournaments or whatever when you're playing the teams you're so familiar with. Okay, so a team that's Fairfield. Good team, okay. They got the better of them that night, barely.
So, do you think size plays a role here? Caleb Middlesworth, 6'8", a big kid. They kind of have a really good inside-outside game at Oak Hill. Middlesworth, Spencer Ballinger, both headed to Huntington University at the end of the season. Mm-hmm. Does that size play a big factor in this game? Westview's not real small, but they don't have 6'8".
Right. I think Westview, the fact that they are – across the board, a pretty decently tall team. Mm-hmm. I mean, when all things considered, they're a lengthy team. Charlie Yoder, lengthy kid, Elijah Hales. I mean, those guys are big enough. I don't know if that's going to be a huge factor. I would have to see Oak Hill, what is the strength level of these guys? You know, are they big 6'8 dudes? Are they skinny 6'8 dudes? I mean, sometimes that makes a difference. But Westview, I feel like Westview has played enough different styles, enough different players, and they're very well coached that I think they'll be able to handle any sort of size situation. So then I think it comes down to execution.
Yeah. Now, you have more experience on Westview than anybody else in the city of Fort Wayne. You did a story on them earlier this year. You've talked to Coach Rob Yoder this week. Tell me a little bit about their depth, because you have three guys, and Charlie Yoder and Elijah Hales and Nick Rensberger, who are capable of putting up big numbers any game. Each of them have 30-plus point games this year. How do you defend a team like that?
That's a pretty good question. I don't know, because that's part of their strength, Westview, in that they don't have to rely on one guy as their scoring leader. I mean, they are – Charlie Yoder is a great player. He could do a lot of different things. He's a sophomore, coach's son. So we know all the things that go into that when you're a coach's son and you see the game. You should, anyway, see the game better than some of the other players. So he's a factor there. I think that they have been able to they don't play necessarily a three-point game, but they're good at three-point shooting. Mm-hmm. You know, they're good at moving the ball. They're good at get spacing, finding their shots, and they're patient. And I think that's a big factor.
6 o'clock on Saturday, Oak Hill and Westview, a trip to Bankers Life, a trip to the state finals in Class 2A. I'm going to do what Justin does to me every week. How many teams are we watching in Bankers Life next weekend?
Oh, they're both going.
Both going?
Yep.
Reggie Hayes said it. I'm going to agree with you. I thought they would both get here this week. They were the two teams I thought would win regionals. And I think Oak Hill presents an interesting challenge for Westview. But like you said, you don't get to 28-1 by being a slouch.
Right.
So we'll see if we're right. Either we'll be back here next week. Maybe you'll come back. Maybe I'll replace Justin full time.
If I'm right, I'm both. I don't know if we can let Kenny back in here.
That's true. Justin Kinney's out. If Blackhawk Christian and Westview win, maybe that's an extra motivator. We'll find out. This Saturday, Huntington North, 4 o'clock, 6 o'clock, great doubleheader, and hopefully we'll be back with you again next week.
There you go.
Thanks for joining us.